Good day. A couple videos ago, I introduced you to something I consider to be revolutionary for our FPV community and beyond. It's called Gyroflow. Gyroflow is a gyro-assisted, free video stabilization software tool for aerial videography and other stuff currently under open source development by Elvin Chen, whose site I'll link to in the video description below. There are a lot of things I like about Gyroflow. Gyroflow does a good job at video stabilization, it's free, and it can be used with just about any camera. To use Gyroflow to stabilize video with your specific camera, you just need to introduce Gyroflow to your camera through a computer file known as a lens preset file so they can get to know each other. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make that introduction and create the lens preset file in just two steps for your specific camera so you can use Gyroflow for free to stabilize your FPV drone videos. If this sounds good to you, make sure to give this video a thumbs up below and subscribe to your TMAC FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. As I mentioned, this video is the second in the Gyroflow series, so we're going to start with having already downloaded and installed Gyroflow. If you haven't yet watched the first Gyroflow video, I've got a link to it down in the video description below. So we run Gyroflow by clicking on the executable file, and our two windows pop up. To stabilize our flight video clip, we click on the Video Stabilizer button, and we see here we have three things we need to upload, which we did in the previous Gyroflow video. One of the things we need is our lens preset file for our specific camera and settings. The first thing I'd recommend doing is going to the Gyroflow website, gyroflow.xyz, and checking to see if your specific camera and settings you use to capture your flight video footage are either in the available presets zipped file you can download and extract, or have been recently added on the GitHub site. If you find your camera and settings in a file on the GitHub site, such as for the Foxeer Digisight Nano camera for use with SharkBite, just left-click on the file, then click on Raw. Next, just right-click your mouse button and save as a JSON file to a Gyroflow camera presets folder you've made on your computer to keep organized. If you found a camera preset file with the settings you've used, then you just use that file, as I demonstrated in the first video of the series, and you don't need to create one yourself. However, if your camera and settings are not part of the available Gyroflow camera presets library yet, then the simple process I'm about to demonstrate is what you'll want to do. Let's go back to our Gyroflow windows we've opened. Since we haven't found a preset file for our specific camera and settings, we just click on this camera calibrator button. This brings up this pop-up window asking for a calibration chessboard size. You'll see what that is here shortly, but for now, let's just put in the numbers 11 and 8 and click OK. This will bring up the main window we'll now be working with. This is where we start step number one of our camera's introduction to Gyroflow. We click on File and select Calibration Target. This brings up that calibration chessboard for which we just input the 11:8 size. Let's expand this to full screen. All we're going to do with this is film this on our computer screen using our camera that we want to introduce to Gyroflow using the specific settings that we'll be using in our flights. For instance, we want to make sure we're using the same camera lens, the same field of view, and aspect ratio. For the demo today, I'll be using the Caddx Tarzir dual lens FPV camera that's capable of shooting in 4K 30fps, 2.7K 60fps, or even 1080p 90fps. For this camera, the aspect ratio and field of view is different depending upon the resolution and frame rate we choose. For our demo, I'll be using the 2.7K 60fps setting, which has a 4:3 aspect ratio and 165 degree field of view. When we video record this chessboard using our camera, we want to record it at different angles using our camera. When you're doing that, there's just a couple things to keep in mind. If you have a camera with electronic image stabilization, you're going to want to turn that off to ensure it doesn't mess around with this process. First of all, keep this entire chessboard in your camera's field of view. Secondly, although you can use many different angles, there's a few I'm going to show you that'll definitely help. If this light blue area is your computer screen with the chessboard entirely within your camera's field of view, you'll want to video record the chessboard while it's in the center of your screen, top center, bottom center, middle left, middle right, upper left corner, upper right corner, lower left corner, and lower right corner. This ensures that you've captured the chessboard in all areas of your camera's field of view. You may want to do this for both straight-on views as well as when your camera is tilted at an angle to your screen. As an example, with a chessboard in the upper left corner of your field of view, you may want your camera pointing down toward the lower right corner at an angle to your screen. For each of these positions and angles, you want to hold your camera as steady as possible for a second or two. This will give you somewhere between 9 and 18 different positions and angles. You can do more if you'd like to include views where you've rolled your camera to the left and or to the right. Once you're done recording these different positions and angles, just save the recorded video somewhere to your computer, because next, in step number 2, we're going to use it. For step 2, we go back to our main calibration window and go to File, Open File, and we grab that video from our computer we just recorded of the chessboard. Once it's uploaded, we can select Play and pause the video at those positions and angles we just recorded when our camera was steady and the image isn't blurry. We'll start with the view when our chessboard is in the center of our screen. We select Pause, then select Add Current Frame. And you'll see some diagonal parallel lines Gyroflow has created. Next, we'll go to the view when our chessboard is at the center and top, select Pause, select Add Frame. We'll do the same when the checkerboard's at the center bottom. Pause, add current frame. Once we have a few frames selected, we'll press this other button over here that says Process Loaded Frames. When we do that, we should get an RMS error less than 1. If we don't, if this number shoots to the moon, like to 100 or 300 or something like that, try select Remove Last Frame and then Process Loaded Frames again to see if the RMS number goes down to below 1. We just repeat this process until we've added and processed all of our positions and angles from our video and kept the RMS error value below 1. At any time during this process, to check to see if our calibration is going well, we can just toggle the lens correction over here and compare straight lines between when the lens correction is applied and when it's not applied. So you can see here, the lines are fairly straight. We can move this around throughout the video clip and check to make sure that the lines are straight in various portions of the clip. If the straight lines in both views look similar, not like the corrected lens version has gone through some sort of time warp, and these curved edges don't matter, I'm talking about the image of the checkerboard itself, then you're probably good to go. If this RMS error is less than 1 and the lines look fairly straight on your checkerboard with the lens correction toggled on, then you should be good to go. At this point, it's just a matter of saving this lens preset file you've created. You do that by filling in these fields over here to include the brand and make of your camera, such as CADX, Tarsier, V2, the lens, if your camera has different lenses associated with it, what camera settings you used when making this preset file. In my case, it was actually 2.7K, 4x3, and any other notes you want to add, as well as your name if you'd like. Then you select Export Preset File, and Gyroflow automatically names it for you. You just save it to your camera presets folder on your computer. That's it. You've made your very own Gyroflow preset file for your specific camera and settings. You can now use this file for all of your videos, and you don't need to go through this process again unless you're using a different camera or different settings on your camera that change your camera's field of view or aspect ratio. Now, after you've made your very own lens preset file and confirmed that it does work on your video, if you'd like to share it with the world, simply go back to Gyroflow XYZ and upload it by selecting Add Lens Profile. To see how your new lens profile works for stabilizing your flight video, use the process I demoed in the first video of this series, and you should be left with a stabilized flight video. I'll close with a short stabilized flight video using the preset file we just created during this video. I hope you found this useful, and you get a chance to use Gyroflow for stabilizing your FPV videos. Let me know what you think in the comments section below, and thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.